Land Rover Discovery long-term review. Before you look at the price of this Land Rover Discovery, it's worth noting that more than half of Discovery buyers opt for the top specification trim. Because the price as tested, £74,420, or even perhaps the basic price, £64,195, might cause an involuntary breath to leave your mouth, as it did mine. But this is not unusual, and it speaks of where Land Rover is today. The Discovery is, at the very least, an executive car, nudging towards a luxury car. Take a look around, there are loads of them specced like this. It's a way of having a car that's as luxurious and well-appointed as, oh, I don't know, an up-spec Mercedes-Benz E-Class, or a BMW 7 Series, without anybody thinking that you're on an airport taxi run. We're running this shiny new Discovery, about 10,000 miles on the clock, fresh from its first service, having served a few months' time as a press demonstrator before it came to us, to see how well it will do the whole executive transport thing. Not that I am an executive, or anything like, obviously, but most of my driving is similar to those who will use a Discovery properly, early starts, to hammer along a motorway, and then subject it to the harsher vagaries of domestic duties at the weekend. Besides, they said, you live in the sticks, Prior, so surely a roughy-tufty 4x4 is up your street, while relieving me of the keys to a Mercedes-Benz E-Class wagon, which will now be run by Matt Burt. The E-Class / Discovery handover is an interesting one because, to an extent, they have to do the same things. Sure, the Land Rover has to do more, off-road, and if hauling things, but they could feasibly both end up on your company car list. And for the Discovery's extra versatility, it doesn't necessarily follow that potential buyers will cut it too much slack when they come to picking between the two. But buyers should be aware. As a strict road car, the Mercedes is, ultimately, the nicer thing to drive. Lower, more agile, more economical at the same performance levels.